Tiana Talon says, I heard Lane Norton discussing ways to maximize muscle protein synthesis. One of the rate limiters he discussed was leucine levels. He said that 3 grams of leucine would maximize muscle protein synthesis at each feeding. Does this make sense based on your knowledge? So this is something that I take, this is something that Alex Leaf is much better versed on than I am. And so I'm going to tell you what I've taken out of my conversations with him, even though you'd probably get a better answer from him. So leucine is metabolized into a leucine metabolite that is the signal of protein synthesis. It's the thing that tells your muscles whether they should be synthesizing protein. But do you synthesize more protein when you upregulate all the factors of muscle protein synthesis? Well, that is entirely dependent on the amount of amino acids you have supplied. And so does it make any, you know, think about it this way. Why is leucine used as the marker to determine how much muscle protein to make? Because usually when you get leucine, it's with high quality protein that has all the other amino acids that you need to make muscle protein. And so my impression is that all of the research is leading to the fact that there is absolutely nothing more superior than eating protein from whole foods, and that everything is inferior to it. And there's a lot to work out in details. Like, I don't know if it's true that eating lentils at, you know, adjusted for the essential amino, or adjusted for an index of protein quality to adjust the amount of protein is better than whey protein. I don't know. But eggs are better than isolated proteins. That's been shown. And it's probably because there are other things. And now the question is meat better than isolated protein? I don't know. So the research is pointing in the direction that at least some whole foods are just better than protein supplements, number one. Perhaps as a general principle, perhaps whole protein foods are better than protein supplements, number two. And number three, taking leucine or the leucine metabolite that regulates muscle protein synthesis is not going to be better than getting whole proteins, even from protein supplements, when you get enough protein to provide that leucine. Because the leucine and its metabolite don't actually achieve peak muscle protein synthesis unless you supply the protein with it. And if you supply the protein with it, you do get the leucine. So there probably are questions that can still be worked out about this, but there probably is, it's probably going to wind up being that it's a waste of time to take the leucine if you're getting enough protein, and it's stupid to take the leucine and not get enough protein. And so you should just eat a lot of protein, is where I think this is going. All right, thanks, Tiana, for your question.